good technique makes someone want to do something, doesn't force them to do it. Takes no physical strength. Always think structure over strength. Never physical strength, structure over strength. As long as you pay attention to structure over strength, you eliminate gender, size, strength level, all that stuff. Let the technique and the technique of the action, or you understanding the technique of the respective action, work for you and not your physical strength. Physical strength only goes but so far, right? So again, with the clinch flow, it's very important that we bait them into allowing us to connect our shoulder and feet and arm in. The way we do it within this jiu-jitsu class, I use an arm drag. In the street, I would either back fist or smack in the face to make them turn away, or kick the inside of their leg. For a jiu-jitsu class, I'm going to try to convince this person that I'm trying to move to the back, so I pull them and make them turn just like that and feed the arm in, just like that. That's your mission. So we go through, boom, boom, feed it in. Now I just blanket this elbow with my palm just like so. This is not a full wrap on this side. This is just a blanket of the elbow right here. Now I pull, turn, replace my hand with my crown, push through his head, fully wrap over here, low, full wrap on this side, stand up right here, light touch right here. This is what's keeping me attached to him. Then a sharp wrap, grab, touch as I pummel through, and that's where it is. And this person goes. Technique or this flow is just it's put together in such a way where you can practice each technique in a flow to make it easier to remember, easier to retain, get you some transitioning through. That's what it's designed for. But each one stands on their own. Much like a socket set, when you buy a socket set, comes on the tree, and you got the different sockets, 7/16, 1/4 inch, all these different sockets. When you grab your set on that tree, it's easier to carry. And you see the problem, you take off the one you need, and you use it. That's why everything I do is put in sets, so it's easier to carry, right? But they each stand alone. So now what we're gonna do is just address certain issues, certain things that happen. So let's say I'm moving around, somebody grabs a collar tie. All I'm going to do is zombie the arm that collar ties me. First I'm gonna secure a collar tie when they collar tie, and then I'm going to zombie and move in that direction to their right. So I'm standing here, I zombie and move in there, which makes them pull their hand down and around and gives me this automatic. You understand? So in the process, he grabs a collar tie, I grab a collar tie, I move over, he comes in, and get right in him. You see it? One more time. Right here, I move in this direction, he turns, and here right here. Alright? So dealing with the collar tie, we zombie. Right? So we're standing here, I grab a collar tie, you grab a collar tie. There you go. Now you zombie in and move to that direction. Which makes me do this. You understand? Don't do this. Grab on. Don't do this. Try to push out. Just push in and move in that direction. Okay? Just keep moving in that direction. With the intention of turning and grabbing the wrist. You understand? So, I grab a collar tie. Go in, move. There you go. Just like that. Make sense? Yeah. So, we bait up collar ties. I grab, you grab. Zombie. Move in. Like that. Make sense? See how it worked?
Yeah.
Now we're gonna stiff arm. We're the Heisman. So we're standing here. We're standing here. All I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna stiff arm against your body as I keep moving forward. Then switch hands. Okay. So one more time. Standing here. I come just like so. So we're standing right here. All you do is stiff arm. Don't grab. Just stiff arm. Just like that. See it? And keep moving forward. And then switch your hand. Boom. Now circle around. All I do is go just like this. See? Just get them moving backwards. So all you gotta do is get them moving backwards with this. stiff. This. I don't want to do this to get that arm. I'm just standing here just like this. I'm just standing here. Let's go. Yeah. When I get this against you, like this, then I go like this, you'll push off or turn. Which gives me space. Yeah. So you don't have to angle yourself. Just stand like that, right there, and stiff arm. Yeah, boom. Just like that. Keep moving forward. Yeah. Yeah, I moved it off.
Yeah.
As I'm moving, I'm trying to move right off. That fits you right in. Yeah. Specific, I'm just boom, pinning it. So I just go just like that. See, I always got that. And then I replace with my body to keep it attached. See it? See, I go like this, and then go like this, and replace with my body. You see? So I go. This place, this foot underneath this one. No. Like that. Now, this one stays straight. This one just slides up.
Like this one stays straight?
Yep. Slide this one up like this. Watch this. Up my feet. This is underneath your neck. This is on top. This is the only one moving.
Oh, okay. Underneath. On top.
Yep. Like that. Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, this is just a natural beam. See it? Just right there. Go like this. Yeah.
So recover the head with this one.
No, that one is when you wanna. When you step over and pull back, that's when I wanna switch my hands. That's not occupying your mind, so I can switch my hand, lay on you and switch my hand.
Oh, okay.
You see it?
Yeah.
Then I drop to my knee. Right? Knee. As soon as I switch my hands, I drop to my knee. So I'm sitting over you just like this over your head. And I make a decision what I want to do from here. Either I'm gonna lay down, or I'm just gonna stay up for it to gather and boom. Yeah. So just this part is when I step over, lay down, switch my hand. And then around. Okay. And the side.
So you want to step if you're going to choke with that leg? With the legs like that? You would step, right?
It's to switch my hands. I have to switch my hands. You have to switch your hands. See, so when you're down like this, right? I just took you down. I go like this. Just to switch my hands.
Okay.
Then I go here and I make a decision. Either I'm coming here. See it? Or I'm just gonna gonna stay here and pump your ribs.
Alright.
Okay? Yeah. Stepping over and pulling back is just to get you to be like this so I can switch my hands without. Because if I don't do that and I go to switch my hands, you can start trying to escape. So I just occupy your mind by pulling your neck. Is that it? Like this, if I make the decision to lay down, I'm already gonna go like this. So then when I go like this, all I gotta do is that. See?
Yeah.
So I'm like this, I make a decision to lay down, I go like this automatically. Then I lay down, extend this.
So it's important that this left foot. The left foot is in the bottom.
This.
Right?
My left foot
yeah.
is on bottom, yep. This. So then when you lay down, all you gotta do is, yep, just like that. And just slide that. And then this stays as a beam, and this one is the one that's doing the choking. You see it? Because you don't want it to be like this, to be like this, and to have you. You don't want to squeeze like this. You want this to just almost chop. Yeah, this is just straight. And this one's going to chop. It's like peeling my chin up and getting access to my neck. You see what I'm saying? So if I know I'm going to do that, I'll be here and I'll release it all over automatically. Boom. Automatically. When I fall, it's automatically there. Make sense? Now, same thing. This time we're gonna, doesn't matter what we do, we're gonna stiff arm or go to collar tie in zombie, right? And seize the control position, and then the person's gonna try to move back and pull out of it, we're going with a single. I can test the single. You see it? So if I'm right here and I go like this, I go like this, boom, go like this, and then you start pulling out, trying to, yep, move, and I go, boom. Now, it comes this way. Make sense? Go right here. And you go, boom. Just the clinch flow, when I push on your face, straighten my arm, and when I'm like this, my chest goes real close to your leg. So if I'm like this, right? If I'm like this and I go like this, watch my chest. See how close I am to your leg?
Yeah.
So all I gotta do is this. You see what I mean? So this gives me close proximity, and this shit gives me close proximity because you're trying to push me on. If you got me, I'm like this. See it? You understand? It's right there for you. Because either I'm doing this, or I'm doing this. But either way, you just keep walking towards me. Go. See it? Either way. Even when I'm like this, either you're trying to stay stationary and your head's being pushed, or you're moving away because your head's being pushed. Either way, you're giving me that leg because you're occupied with all the other shit. You see what I mean? Let's go to the ground now. Now they all connect. This is where the 10th planet mind meld comes in.
Yeah, I want to work on that.
Electric chair?
Yes.
Yeah. All right, here's the thing. We're going to get it from standing up, right? So we're going to get to the third clinch, which is this, right? And I'm down low so you can't get your arm, right? So either you make them post that hand, this hand, and getting low, or if they don't post it, you put your foot on their hip, right? As you drop onto your side. If they do post it, all you gotta do is drop and bring your ankle up into their groin and then slide down to their knee. You see what I'm saying? So as I'm standing here, I'm getting low to try to make you post that hand. If you do, then all I gotta do is drop down like this. Boom, see it? And bring this up as I fight, just like this. See it? Now, what happens is you end up pushing my knee down, right? Drop it, there you go. Now push it between your legs. See it? And it gets too far over, right? So I can't bring it back, so I let this go. Come here, block that. See it?
Yeah.
So all I did was this. I was here, right? All of a sudden you push this down and trapped it. Now it's putting too much pressure on my knee because you're trying to pass. So I let this go. This is over between your legs. Drop this down, boom, put this under your foot. Now I'm in lockdown. See it? And that's where we're gonna start our electric chair from. You see it?
Yeah.
So we're right here, stand up. So we're right here, and however you get there, doesn't even matter, right? We're right here. If you wanna, zombie, go. Boom, right there. Then you get strapped, get collar tied, boom, get low. Oh, see, it gets trapped, so I can't pull it in front. Get low. I go like this. Just drop down, bring your ankle up into my ground, boom, just like that. You see it? And fire, and flip. Boom, just like there. Now I'm right here like this, so I go. And I start putting a lot of pressure on your leg like that. So you bring that in, grab a lock, boom, just like so. Now it becomes this. Yep, you hop up, there you go. Now we're right here, just like this, right? Get electric underhooks, right here, there you go. Now I'm trying to fight this, you understand?
Yeah.
Now all you're gonna do is whip down. That means you're gonna lay on your back, bring your knees to your chest, boom, and extend this way, boom. See, now I'm right here, like this. You see it? Now, yep, drag your elbow in, get up, move back a little bit. No, on your elbow, there you go. Bring this down. Able grip your hands. Alright, just like so, doesn't matter. Now listen. Extend your legs and roll your chest out to the ground. See?
Yeah. So game grip here.
Yeah, right there. Yep. Extend your legs and roll your chest to the ground. Roll your chest to the ground. Just roll way up. Yeah. You see it? You understand? So the important part, you know where you want to go. You know he's gonna try to stuff your knee in, circle around. That's what people do. right? So when they stuff, you can try to fight it. What stops the stuff is for you to meat hook. You're not just gonna meat hook, you're fucking. You wanna go lockdown, so you just let them stuff, right? Drop your leg, boom. Get them in lockdown, get electric underhooks, right? And just curl them, you know? Stay there, and then whip down. That's called a whip down. When you're like this, and you come, boom, and extend your legs, and then right going down. It makes him have to post. If he doesn't post, he'll roll over, and he'll pass his guard, so he's gonna post. You see it? And that's when you, up, boom, get over it, extend, and lay down, boom. See it? So it looks like this. My hair, whatever I decide to do. You want to do it, doesn't matter. But the key is to get this collar tie armor trap without them being able to escape it in front. So that's why you have to stay low. I'm low like this. It's hard to escape. See? Now just right here. I mean, you post right over. If you don't post, you go like this. Extend your body. Down here. So you can't come back. See it? Go. Try to come back. See it? It keeps me at that distance. Now all I gotta do is this. See it? It's above your knee. Extend and roll down. See it?
Yeah.
Don't go. As this is here.
Alright. What if somebody's bringing the hips towards you.
Like what?
Like pushing their hips towards you, using their pose.
Yeah, go, oh,
yeah.
Push.
Yeah,
fit.
Yeah.
That's what this is for. To stop.
Yeah. So that's important.
Yep.
If you don't have that, you might move your position.
Yeah,
you could. Yeah.
But you still have a lockdown, so you could just go back.
Yeah.
Go back. But you can. You're good. Either way, or you go electric storm sweep. That's what that's designed for. If they start pushing that down. So if I got shown a lockdown, and I get you here, boom, boom, I'm right here, and you start pushing back, I can go like this, and let you push back, push, and I go electric stone sweep. The mission is to trap that arm and to understand how to get to that arm. If I do decide to just come here, boom, 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 and I want that, I'll just go. See? There I go. So all I did was from here, just here. From here. Boom. Now, I got to figure out. I'm good. Nice. I'm good. You just go where you want to go. Make sense?
Yeah.
Once you have connection, you can go to any clinch you want by understanding how, you know? I attach, I know. Your reaction is going to tell me what to do. You start pulling away. You're telling me to take the uncontested single. You stay stationary, you're telling me to throw you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So when you're repping these, it's good to get different reactions.
Yeah, a person will.
Yeah.
It's good to switch partners at will. Yeah. That's why I usually say at the beginning of class, switch partners at will. Mm-hmm. Don't wait for me to tell you to switch. Switch partners at will. That way you get a different feel of different people's reactions. There's only so many ways you can react to me. You know what I'm saying? There's only so many ways. And it's just one person might put their hand on my neck and try to pull off more than somebody else. Somebody else might just hunker down and try to, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, so that one person represents a million people in this world. The next person represents 2 million people in this world, how they react. So when you're working out with one person, you're really working out with like a million. It's all about stalling your action. As soon as you grab a collar tie, I go like this, I just stalled your action. I attach my shoulder, I can throw you. At will. At will. I know, as soon as I touch and attach my shoulder to yours, I can throw you. At will. I just stalled your action. You see what I mean? So, that's what I thought. Stall the person's action. When I step over your face, pull my heel back, and get your neck like that, I stall your action. All I need is 2 seconds, 3 seconds stall to switch to what I want to do. You see what I'm saying? Everything about what I do is stall. When I throw you and then climb on top of you, it's to stall your action. You know what I'm saying? If we're street fighting and I go like this, that right there stalls your action. So I go, bang, and just reach up your leg. So you can get kicked in the face. It's all about stalling their action. Make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just the way when they're powering down, they think that they got something. But I go like this. I drop on the inside of your leg, and I grab your waist and put my ear on the side of your back. And then I push into you like this as I windshield wipe this leg. Push in, windshield wipe this leg, which will make you drop, and then hop around out of your legs. So again, come right here like this. You power out and you go like this, right? Just like this. You know what I'm saying? Just like this, right? Right here and go.
see, I don't stay here, so you can grab me, hop around like this, away from your legs. See it?
And that's when you reach through. You just start straightening your arm and going down to the ground, but it doesn't matter how you look. People start doing shit like that. So, if they start doing that, I just go like this. And then put this on the ground like this. And stall your action by laying down like this. And taking this arm that's behind you, grab it. And right here.
Yeah, that's crazy because I was looking at it like fitting it to on counter chokes, like arm triangles. That's what it is, right?
Yeah.
So that's
it's a darce, really.
Darce?
The difference between an anaconda and a darce is one goes from armpit to neck, other one goes from neck to armpit. That's the difference.
So it looks the same.
Yeah. So one would go like this. Yeah. The other would go like this. Armpit to neck, neck to armpit. Malibu beams. This position. Stop shit like that.
Beans get you out of there?
Yeah.
Great job. Great job. You see that?
Yeah.
Malibu beans.
Whew.
Great.
We're calling that a lot, man. Like north, south, arm triangle. Never know.
Just did it.
Yeah.
Okay. Great job. Great job.